Hello, aviation enthusiasts, and welcome back to Histories of Airliners. The roar of radial engine, the glint of polished aluminum, the promise of a journey across continents, these are the hallmarks of an era when aviation was still finding its wings. This is the story of three companies, Consolidated, Vultee, and Convair, whose names became synonymous with innovation and progress in the burgeoning world of commercial airliners. From the streamlined Vultee V1, a pioneering attempt at a modern airliner, to Consolidated's aquatic workhorse, the Consolidated Commodore, which was developed from an aircraft initially designed for the U.S. Navy, laid the groundwork for future transport designs, and finally the sleek pressurized Convair 880 and 990, built to challenge the dominance of the jet age. These manufacturers left an indelible mark in the history of flight. Join us as we explore the triumphs and tribulations, the groundbreaking designs, and the ultimate legacies of the aircraft that helped shrink the globe and connect the world. Originally developed from the XPY-1 Admiral that was originally developed for a U.S. Navy contract for a seaplane transport aircraft, the Consolidated Commodore was designed and built to transport passengers long distances in relative comfort. This wasn't just an airplane, it was a flying boat, a luxurious airliner designed to bridge continents and connect cities separated by vast stretches of ocean. From the glamorous days of Pan American World Airways Clippers to its service with smaller airlines, usually Pan American subsidiaries, and even military roles, the Commodore's story is a fascinating chapter in aviation history. The prototype aircraft first flew on 28 September of 1929. From there, it would fly for a predecessor airline to Pan America before ending its career in 1938, flying for Pan Air do Brasil. One survivor remains, pulled from the depths of a Canadian lake. It is, according to records, undergoing restoration by the San Diego Air and Space Museum. The Vultee V1. For a brief, shining moment, it represented the future of commercial air travel. Sleek, all-metal, and boasting a then-revolutionary monoplane design, the V1 promised to usher in a new era of speed and efficiency. But its story is more than just a tale of groundbreaking technology. It's a story of ambition, innovation, and the harsh realities of early aviation. From its record-breaking flights to its tragic accidents, the V1's journey is a microcosm of the challenges and triumphs of aviation in the 1930s. Ultimately, 25, including the prototype, were constructed, most early in their careers flying for American Airlines. However, the changes in regulations on airliners made single-engine and single-pilot airliners unfeasible. Many of these aircraft would find their way to both sides of the Spanish Civil War, while the prototype itself was eventually broken up for scrap after retiring. One example of this type exists, and it is on display at the Aviation Museum at the Shannon Airport in Fredericksburg, Virginia. The Convair 110, a name perhaps not as instantly recognizable as some of its contemporaries, yet this aircraft played a crucial role in the evolution of regional air travel. Born from the ambitious post-war vision of Consolidated Vultee aircraft, the forerunner of Convair, the 110 represented a step towards the more efficient and comfortable short to medium haul flights. Though only a prototype was built, and its service life was somewhat limited, mostly to testing for the Convair 240, the Convair 110 story is a fascinating glimpse into the challenges and innovations of early commercial aviation. As we stated, only one unpressurized Convair 110 was built before American Airlines changed the requirements for the new airliner. This would ultimately produce the Convair 240, which was pressurized and carried more passengers. The Convair 110 was broken up for scrap a little over a year after its first flight. The Convair 240, in the immediate post-war era, as the world looked towards a future of expanded air travel, this twin-engine airliner emerged as a key player. Sleek and pressurized, the 240 promised a more comfortable and efficient flying experience for passengers on regional routes. From its initial service with American Airlines to its widespread use across the globe, the Convair 240 became a familiar sight on tarmacs, connecting cities and bridging distances. But its story is more than just its technical specifications. It's a tale of competition, innovation, and the evolving landscape of commercial aviation. The Convair 240 would go on to spawn a family of improved airliners, where most airlines could upgrade from one type to another in their own hangars by swapping out engines and other equipment. The prototype aircraft would serve a long life as a testbed for Convair, including the use of turbine-powered engines to drive the propellers. Eventually, this aircraft would be broken up for recycling sometime around the year 2000. The roar of four jet engines, the sleek lines of a swept wing, the promise of near supersonic speed. The Convair 880 was built to challenge the giants of the jet age. Conceived as a faster, more luxurious alternative to the early Boeing 707 and the Douglas DC-8, the 880 aimed to capture a slice of the burgeoning jetliner market. Its story, however, is one of both dazzling performance and complex challenges. From its record-breaking speeds to its struggle in the marketplace, the Convair 880's journey is a fascinating chapter in aviation history. The Convair 880 type would be relatively short-lived, as fuel prices hurt many airlines' bottom line, with no one willing to pay that much more for just a little more speed over the 707 and the DC-8. The prototype itself, after a rather interesting testing period, in which in one flight it survived losing most of its vertical stabilizer, would fly for Northeast Airlines and Transworld Airlines before being taken up by private ownership and eventual breakup around 2011. The Convair 990 Coronado. Born from a desire to push the boundaries of jet airliner performance, this sleek four-engine aircraft represented the pinnacle of Convair's commercial aviation ambitions. Designed to be even faster than its predecessor, the Convair 880, the 990 boasted an impressive cruise speed and a distinctive, almost futuristic design. But its story is one of both innovation and commercial challenges. From its cutting-edge technology to the economic realities that ultimately limited its production, the 990's journey is a complex and compelling chapter in the history of jet-powered flight. Again, like the Convair 880, the 990's speed was offset by the rising fuel prices of the day. This turn of events only allowed for 37 aircraft to be built. The prototype aircraft would go on to become an airborne observatory for NASA in 1965 and fly that mission until the aircraft was destroyed in a mid-air collision with a U.S. Navy P-3 Orion in 1973. Pan American ordered 15 Convair Model 37 double-decker airliners based on the United States Air Force XC-99 aircraft. But with no orders coming from any other airline, and the United States Air Force not ordering any more XC-99s, the project was financially untenable, and all we are left with today are remnants of the XC-99 prototype that may one day be restored to its original beauty. From the streamlined elegance of Vultee's early V-1 airliner and the Consolidated Commodore seaplane, to the wartime production might of Consolidated that paved the way for future transports, and finally the jet-age aspirations of Convair's groundbreaking designs. These three companies wove a complex and compelling tapestry in the story of aviation. Their individual contributions, often born of innovation and driven by ambition, collectively shaped the landscape of commercial flight. The aircraft they produced, from the pioneering V-1 to the near supersonic aspirations of the Convair 990 Coronado, weren't just machines. They were symbols of progress, connecting continents and shrinking the globe. The legacies of Vultee, Consolidated, and Convair remind us that the history of flight is not just about metal and engines, but the visionaries, engineers, and pilots who dared to dream of a world connected by air. We hope you've enjoyed this exploration of the intertwined histories of Vultee, Consolidated, and Convair. If you found this video informative, please consider supporting our channel. Liking this video, subscribing for more content, and sharing it with fellow aviation enthusiasts are all invaluable ways to help us continue creating more videos like this. You can support us through our Patreon page. Every contribution, big or small, helps us delve deeper into the fascinating world of aviation history. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.